Welcome back here at the Tech Talk Studio, the NCSS One Conference. And we're now here with Marnix Dekker, Information Security Officer at ENISA. And ESA stands for the European Union Network and Information Security Agency. You've been here at the conference, seen many talks. We haven't talked yet about the European cloud strategy, especially as one of the responses on the Snowden revelations on the NSA, eavesdropping and all sorts of European information, especially Germany and France said we need to keep data in Europe. What are your thoughts from ENISA on European cloud strategy?
The cloud strategy really came from the perspective of innovation and jobs, right? So it's really, they really said, you know, let's all move over to the cloud and, you know, our economy is going to be better. IT costs are going to be lower. It's true that there's a lot of countries and member states that are complaining about data privacy, data moving across borders and so on. But there's a lot of security benefits. In fact, I'm a bit surprised that cloud is not more prominent at this conference because...
Yeah. Could be more prominent at the conference.
We see cloud also as an opportunity, really. If you see that a lot of small and medium-sized enterprises, they're moving to the cloud, and that means that they are not maintaining servers anymore, they don't need to hire experts anymore or network administrators, and then suddenly you see their systems become more standard, better maintained, they suddenly have 24/7 instant response, they have multiple data centers across the globe. I mean, they become much more robust in security terms.
So that's yes. Of course, there's great economic opportunities in making it more efficient. But there's also some cloud providers who say, well, if the European cloud is more privacy-proof, that's a business advantage too. Then the rest of the world can come to us and not to, let's say, the Amazon servers where everybody just sneaks in.
Oh, for sure. I mean, you see now a number of big U.S. providers moving to Europe.
They are.
Or really strongly looking at Europe. Yeah, they're either looking for specific models that fit better with the European requirements. And I really think that that Europe has an opportunity here. Mm-hmm. But it's difficult, I think, to get very strong privacy restrictions in place. But I think it's an opportunity.
It sounds positive as an opportunity, but... Can you really geographically seal off cloud?
No, I don't think that is really necessary. I think there should be much more transparency about where data goes, mm-hmm. who has jurisdiction, who is the company that is actually dealing with your data, and which kind of law enforcement agencies knock on their doors,
and
you know, what kind of protection measures do they have? How transparent are they about these things? That's really important. And then. There are people now saying, you know, let's have our own national cloud. And our commissioner, Nelly Kroes, said that would be a very stupid idea, right? Because then we would have 28 small EU clouds, and you know, we wouldn't have a single market. But then there were others that say, okay, let's make one EU cloud. But then, you know, there were people saying, yeah, but the UK would be there as well, and we don't really trust the UK either with the NSA scandal. So, I mean, also a European cloud is not really a solution. I really think that, we should, you know, embrace the new model of cloud computing and be more transparent about where data goes and allow customers to have a choice.
Yes.
If you want a data center in Iceland and one in Finland, you know, you should be able to set that up.
Okay. Well, do we have other options? Good encryption, better legislation. What are the kinds of solutions you're thinking about at ENISA?
I mean, encryption is a nice question you're asking. So for communications, encryption are really powerful. So there's a really good way to encrypt communication from A to B.
But not on a cloud.
When you start to do processing or when you start to do the stuff that we are used to doing in a cloud, like sharing documents with others or trying to find matches in calendars, this kind of stuff, it has been shown that there is not a good cryptographic solution for that. So there are already mathematical proofs that show the impossibility of cryptography as a solution. So that's a bummer.
Not that one. Other ones?
No alternative to trusting your cloud provider, really.
Yes.
Other ones, well, I mean, a big progress is to be expected in the area of data protection. That's still a jungle. People don't really understand what the deal is, what the rules are, and every rule in every country is different.
Yeah.
So if they can harmonize better, then at least European companies will be able to sell across the European digital market. And that will make them stronger.
Yeah. So what is your perspective on the current privacy regulation? Is it going too far or not far enough?
I'm not a data protection expert, to be honest. I think there's a lot of focus on sanctions. unfortunately. I think there should be much more focus on how do we collaborate with industry to deliver what citizens want. Sometimes I feel, governments not completely be in touch with their citizens. You know, when they, for example, ban a certain website, but you know, the citizens also continue to use it. So I think there's a lot we can do still with collaborating with the industry for sure. But for the rest, if you can see in security, we still have a very old model of dealing with things like certification. I mean, there's a once in a year or once every 2 years, there's an auditor coming that's going to check your processes. And they have been trying to expand that into privacy, looking at privacy seals and so on. But there are new cloud ways of developing software where they actually change the software 10 times a day.
Yes.
So we will have to look more at things like continuous monitoring of cloud services, websites, and see how to fit that into supervision and regulation.
Okay. We're here now at the NSC One conference. We're almost at the end of the conference. You followed some of the sessions, some of the keynote speakers. What was most impressive to you? What did you learn these last 2 days?
Wow. What did I learn? I learned that these kind of events are really, really important for the community, and I really want to make another one myself, but European-wide. And I, that's
make
really
one
something.
European-wide? You're working on something like that?
Well, I will go home with some plans for sure.
Okay.
What I liked a lot was the talk by John Callas this morning, where he really said, mobile security is much better than the security we had on PCs. And that was really a nice message, I think, and a positive message.
Simon Circle moved from the US to Switzerland, right?
Yeah.
So Google Europe is doing good?
Yeah, Google is moving their incubators to London. I think Vodafone is moving back. So it's
Europe isn't doing that bad after all, right? Actually doing good.
How did we manage?
How do we manage? Okay. Thank you very much. Morning.
Thanks a lot. Thanks.